guys, it's Tandy Gamer, host of Link, and today we're going to be reviewing a fan game, Sonic Explorer. I played the game, and wow, my mouth and my eyes watered in seconds. Not even minutes, but seconds. To be honest, I almost just never wanted to see a Sonic fan game after this ever again. This game is absolutely horrible. Like, there's no point. Stop going first, go through the tutorial, go through the second stage, go through over and over and over again. So isn't that difficult? Yeah, many people, just by in the beginning. We already know that our team, Cap and I, this is a horrible game. I'm gonna go through some reasons why I think it's a very horrible game. First of all, I want to give a big shout out to the person who produced this video and fan game. BlueBeeper60, don't forget to subscribe and like to his channel. And I will leave a link in the description below. So, many people might already like this game. So, to make it feel like I'm not trying to ruin your favorite fan game, you should probably stop watching right now or skip ahead to what I say, some stuff you may not want to hear. And if you really want to skip to, probably 5 minutes ahead if you like this game. So I'm really going to be talking to you about the game for a very good reason, because the game, okay, let's not even want to go to top fast. The obstacles are cheap. It's way of saying that an obstacle is cheap is just by making it like that. Sonic is a platformer. And this is nothing close to what Sonic of these days, of 3D days and Boost means. I mean, in order to make you a platformer, having to put on platforms and you need to jump on from regular things, like you go back to Sonic CD, an enjoyable game. Like, go there and get some advice, but don't look up the original thing. I mean, yeah, that's the point of making a fan game, trying to contend with something, like the original thing. This game is just the top of my worst nightmare when it comes to Sonic games. It's so shallow. It has no type of like extra thing to it, like game like SNL1, Sonic Advance. It's just like that. And it's just so boring. Nothing around to do. You face the same enemies over and over. Like, if you wanted to make a good demo, like put Eggman in it, put like Robotnik and enemy, something, all this easy to destroy robots, you call it cheat challenge. And for the fact that you need to boost get the food before you can boost at first, it's so stupid. And the music doesn't complement the game anymore. Like, one inventor about Sonic, the music complements the gameplay. It's supposed to give you the feel of how the game is. But the music just makes my ears want to bleed. Like, the first time I gave it to my little brother, it felt like throwing up. And that actually is much more enjoyable than listening to the song. Sorry, but it's true. Like, it's good in Sonic Lost World because it actually is in a different world, not sea. This is green. This is green or wherever the hell it is. And it's on Earth, and why would you want to put this in easy? It doesn't make any sense, doesn't correspond to the game. It's horrible. If you are afraid about this game, please, advise you. If you see it ever, don't play. It's for the good of your eyeballs, or your heart, because this game can really make your heart stop pumping blood in your body. Well, that's been another episode. Thanks for watching. As I said, I will be leaving a link on the description of BlueBeeper60. Make sure to like, subscribe to the video. And if you have any opinions on any future video I should make, or any opinion about the game I'm currently making, or the game I'm currently videoing, if you have some views on it, write down in the description below and you may just see the lucky colors of the day, of the week, or the month. Thank you, and goodbye.